Hey guys! Now I thought I'd do a video on relatable university situations because I know a lot of people can probably be like, yeah, I definitely relate to that. Now definitely the first one I'd say is long syllabuses. You know when new term starts and all your module information comes through, you get your piece of paper, like everything that you've got to do, like when your exams are or when what exactly you have to do for your assignments. Yeah, this year I got one which was like 40 pages, I'm not even kidding you. I had like all these different questions, the outline, everything. Like, I looked at it, I was just like... But anyway, I had to read it obviously with no choice. I'd prefer it if it was shorter and then they tell us in class in person. Because sometimes some people like audible things, you want to hear it. Because seeing it, when you see a long page, you're just like, boring. You know that little iPhone emoji with the ZZZZZ thing? That's exactly how I felt. But anyway, like, it's just the thing that happened. Now, another thing I'd say is dense textbook. You know those big textbooks, which are like this big, like the size of a dictionary, and the letters are like this small. Absolutely incredible. How do you expect me to read something like that and stay awake? It's actually not possible sometimes. And then you're literally sitting there wondering, like half an hour later, what did I actually read? Because it's so boring and the information is just, you know, just overwhelming sometimes. Maybe we should, if you guys have like situations where you have that, you find a way to make it interesting, then hook me up because I want to know as well. So yeah, I think another thing is when lecturers call you in a lecture to answer a question which is completely difficult. And sometimes, I know some of you guys may not have been paying attention, or you slept late the last night and you come to lecture like super tired. I don't know if you can relate to that. And another thing is when your lectures are all at 9 a.m.
Yeah. 9 a.m. Seriously?
All lectures start at 12 or 1, maybe even 3 p.m. and then they finish up really late or something like that. That's so beneficial because I don't know about you guys, sometimes I just go to sleep really late. Maybe you're chilling out with your friends or you're just at home watching Netflix. There's a lot of people there. Or reading, as a good student. Another thing is group assignments. Group assignments are literally the worst. Like, you can try as much as you want. There's always going to be someone in the group who doesn't do as much work as everybody else. They think they can just coast and hopefully they'll get a good grade. I know one person that did that, and then we had a group chat and afterwards we got results. Everyone got first, and then this one person got a really bad mark. And you know how we figured it out? They didn't reply. And then when we asked them in person, they're like, it wasn't great. Guys, group assignments are reason for group. The word group. Group, not individual or coasting. But anyway, yeah, and then when you do organise to meet up with people, people just don't turn up. Like, they just think someone else is going to do the work for them. It doesn't work like that. But anyway, another thing for me is definitely when you leave your assignments too late. Guys, I advise you don't do this. Leaving your assignments 2-3 days late or even the night before is not good. You need time to read it, check it, get advice, you know. It's not worth it. Maybe in first year you can get away with that, but I don't know, some people, they just like doing that. I know one guy actually I met, and he said, I finished my dissertation off and got a first, and I did it within 3 days. Maybe he's very smart, maybe he just liked me to show off, but I wouldn't personally use it myself, because that's enough of work to do in this short amount of time. Now yeah, another thing is when you study really hard, and then you get a really bad. Because I know there's some times where you don't try that hard, but you still get really good marks surprisingly. But this time when you read every single textbook under the planet, every book, you get help from every teacher, literally ask your mates, and you're like, yeah, this is, you know, this is like A star, this is like 100%. It comes back, it's not what you expected. And then they just go on and on and say, this could have done this, could have done that. I mean, why didn't you tell me that? I don't know about you guys, but I could definitely relate to that. If you can as well, or there are other things you think university students can relate to, or college, or school in general, just write them below. Subscribe. More stuff coming soon. Stay tuned. See you soon.